It's been a while since I've made a video, and I have been out, but I just haven't been able to film, because it's normally been too dark to film, as the night's drawing in, but here are some of the finds I've been making. At the top here, I was investigating a Victorian bottle dump, and some of the interesting finds coming out were cranberry glass. You see there, that's quite expensive. If that had been complete, that would have been quite a valuable item now, as it was then. We've got some fragments of plate here from the early to mid 20th century. Bottle bottoms. I haven't been able to identify what that means, but there have been quite a few of them. But that will be Victorian, possibly early 20th century. Blue pill and medicine vases. Here the cod stoppers from cod bottles. If I had the complete cod bottles, they'd be quite valuable again. But I found the cod stoppers from them. Again, more bits of plate and a lot of shards of blue glass. And this at the same time, along with your milk and magnesia, cobalt glass was quite a commodity then. Quite a commodity, I say. So the richer blue glasses, such as this one, is quite hard to find nowadays. And this I've reconstructed, as you can see, but it was in three parts originally. But it's a very nice Saxlaner's Bitterfella from the Hyundianos mint bottle making company, as it were. This is very expensive German mineral water from the 1880s, and I believe you can also find them in the States as well, because they were exported all over the world. This is an 1880s bottle, so someone with taste around here was drinking that, and they dumped them. But again, I also find coins. September was quite a meager month for me, but I did find some really nice finds. Top we have this 1949 one shilling cupid nickel. Again, only 3 years off being silver. I was being taunted then to find silver. But I did find my silver for the month, and it was this very nice 1938 sixpence. And 1938 turns out to be the key date of the series for the 50% silver sixpences. It's not worth anything more than any of the others in this grade, but in the higher grades it's worth quite a bit more. Only 12 million of these were minted compared to 22 of the year before or something. So this is quite a rare coin, and I was very happy to find that. Then, as you can see, I have found three pennies. The typical George V penny, dated 1919, nice condition. This one is frankly appalling condition. It's been absolutely eaten alive, and I thought when I found it, oh, this is going to be Victorian, but no, unbelievably this is a George VI, down 7 inches, completely covered in crust, and it's only 60-70 years old, 1946 in date. Then we have this one that was retrieved from the river on the 1st of September. It's a 1965 Elizabeth Old penny. And also this one I recovered on the 30th of September, a very nice 1935 halfpenny, George V, that was on the surface as well, in the woodland. Then we have this absolutely gorgeous 1863 Victoria Bunhead penny, which, if there had been a die number below that date, it would be worth over £1,000 today. But there isn't, but it is a very nice coin anyway, and it's still worth a small amount, but it's not the value to me, it's the history, and this is a beautiful specimen. I did also find an old head Queen Victoria penny, slightly worn on the bust, but in 1897, again attacked by corrosion unfortunately, but clear date. Then we have a very nice 1916 penny, slightly less attacked by corrosion. We also have this, which someone has hit with a plough, not me. You can see that's not me because it's worn inside it, there's dirt inside it, it's not me. 1948 penny that someone struck, sadly, but a nice coin. Then there was this 1799 half penny that I found quite recently in September. I suspect it might even be a forgery because copper doesn't normally chip like this from what I've been finding there. And then finally was this 1942 halfpenny, George VI ship halfpenny. So that was all in all quite a nice month, and I got my silver for the month, but also uncovered a bottle dump.
Well guys, I'm back out again. It's now October. I have been hunting in September, but I haven't had a chance to film, so I've had very limited time, and I wanted to use all that time up for getting vines. I found one silver for that month, and you'll already have seen the pictures. But about being out here 1st of October, been out here about 2 hours now. Sadly, this will probably be a delayed video because people keep stealing the copper cable which connects me to the internet, so the internet keeps going down, so I can't really watch your videos along with the massive pile of work I've been given. But anyway, let's move on with the finds I've been getting. First time I filmed it, 2-inch signal with the Garrett still. Right out here on what looks to be an old abandoned path, and right there is a penny. I've already seen it's George V. It just dropped out the hole there. The date is 1916, an early one. Nice. Looks like it's a bit corroded by the tree line, so there's no patina on it, but it's black. It's nice. I'll wash it up and I'll take a macro feed for you. On to the next. Well guys, back again, sorry for the noise, got to speak up. Got a signal 2 inches, brushed away some leaves as you can see, and look at that. Right on the surface, it looks like it's a coin. It's a penny. That is unbelievable, right on the surface, didn't even have to dig for it. Can't see who it is. Yeah, it's George V. Can't see a date yet, but it looks like an early one, teens probably. Could be 1920, but looks like teens. But that's fantastic, right on the surface. Second George V penny's day. On to the next. Well guys, about half an hour later and I've appeared to have found another coin. It's just here. Looks like the edge of a half penny, or could be a 2p, don't know yet. Looks old, so I'm guessing it's a half penny. Yeah, I can see Britannia on the verse, it's a half penny. George V, or earlier. I think it'll be George V. But that's another lovely find. Her third old coin of the morning / afternoon. Just about to go home and got another old coin. Awesome, on to the next. Well guys, back again. Well, what a difference 1.5 feet can make. Here was the other hole, pretty well filled in. Came over here, got another similar signal, and right there we have another half penny. I'm pretty sure of that looking at the colour. Yeah, that's a ship half penny. Can't see the date, but it might be a Queen Elizabeth II, so probably 50s. But I'd class that as a pocket spill going that way along this path. But awesome, old coin number 4 in 3 hours. That's pretty good. On to the next. Guys, this is getting ridiculous now. Here was where I found that half penny a minute ago, and that one before that. Turned over the path, and look at that, third coin in, 1 or 2 minutes, it's a penny this time. Sorry about the noise, I got people walking past, singing quite loudly. Don't want to rub it, I cannot see who that is. Not sure, could be George V or George VI, probably George VI. That's quite incredible, 3 coins in 3 minutes. Penny and 2 halfpennies. That's old coin number 5 for the day. Awesome. On to the next. Guys, this is now getting absurd. This is another similar signal, coin signal at 4 inches. That was where the penny was. So I think live dig on this. It says 4 inches, but really it's about 2.5, 3 at best. Doesn't matter so much about plugging the woods, but I try and keep it as neat as possible. Anyway, here we are. Just swap hands. It's a root right there. Oop. We've got it out yet. Slightly lower signal now. Not to worry. See, it looks like there was a coin there, so we could be in luck. Yeah. Nope, it's a button. It's a button. Maybe it was from the person who dropped all the other things, but there you are. Can't always get something on live dig. Here's a button. On to the next. I'm back. I'm at this lovely but overgrown dwelling here. There was apparently 4 or 5 small dwellings here in the late 1700s. Been out here, 10 minutes, got a signal, and look at that coin sticking out. Looks like a copper coin, thick, really thick. So I'm thinking early milled halfpenny. But that's fantastic. I've been here 10 minutes and I've already got a coin from this very overgrown but very nice looking location already. There's a well over there. I'll try not to give you too much of the property, but there's a well over there which it had water rights to it, which is quite rare for this period, I'm being led to believe. But this looks like a nice find. I'll wash it up and I'll get back to you. Well guys, this is superb. It's a lovely green copper halfpenny from 1806, George III, which perfectly dates the site. 1790s is the water right, so this is a perfect data of the site, and I've only been here 10 minutes. On to the next.